Didn't take long before we realized this great talent, this great natural ability.
You know, the old equalizer is hard work. Some guys have a lot of ability, but, you know, they don't work as hard.
He's a great, great NHLer.
One of the best leaders in the game of hockey, one of the finest players in the league.
What an ability this guy has to score goals.
Oh, boy. I don't know if he'll ever top that one.
Welcome to the NHL Network's countdown of the top 100 players of all time. I'm Michelle McMahon. For the past 100 years, the National Hockey League has been home to some of the most prolific athletes in all of professional sports. Whether they were innovators of the game or artists on the ice, over the next hour, we will honor those skaters that elevated the sport and the legacies they left behind. Let's kick off our countdown at number 100 with a little royalty.
How about what Henrik Lundqvist has accomplished?
The fans were chanting his name, and he was a rock star right away. This guy's a superstar.
What a save by Lundqvist! Save by Lundqvist! Henrik Lundqvist has joined the 400 club!
It's a marvelous passer, fighting off the check from Slager, but he made the right play.
Number 5, defenseman Mark Hall.
Is quite simply the best defenseman to ever lace up the skates for the Philadelphia Flyers.
The Secretary of Defense, Hall of Famer Rod Langway.
He's the man the Caps look to as far as leadership's concerned in the regular season as well as during the playoffs.
And here's Langway to help out.
And he plays a very physical game as well.
I think you'll see a lot more All-Stars being defensemen.
Aubrey Dick Clapper was a leader and a star during his 20-year tenure with the Boston Bruins. Along with teammate Eddie Shore, Clapper led his team to Stanley Cup glory 3 times. After his retirement in 1947, the customary waiting period was waived and Clapper was elected into the Hockey Hall of Fame that same year.
Shot save again by Quick. It came through and he made the save.
Jonathan Quick gets in these very awkward positions. He gets in the splits position, he's down, he looks like he's out on a play, and he's so explosive going from one side to the other. He is so powerful, he's the strongest goalie, most flexible goalie in the National Hockey League.
This guy, he can do it all now. The most exciting defenseman in the NHL, Erik Karlsson.
They score! Erik Karlsson taps it home! Karlsson fires, scores!
Just a gifted offensive player. See, just magic with the puck.
Denny Savard, number 18. What a spinner and a backhand shot, he scores!
You know, he's probably one of the most exciting players in the game, and he always has been.
Here's Savard, look at the move, he scores! Denny Savard!
He's very creative on the ice, and he's unpredictable, and a lot of times you find yourself standing around watching him, what he's going to do next.
Lidstrom gets it to Larry Murphy.
Murphy a drive, he scores!
Larry Murphy blocked the intended pass back.
Purgatory in Toronto 3 months ago to a Stanley Cup. What a dream for Larry Murphy.
Terry Savard, of course, is the veteran of our defense.
Front for Duguay. He goes to the corner, upended by Savard.
Savard on the right side. He's got three assists. There's that spinorama move working in.
You know, he was a guy that he had a lot of guts and he had a lot of desire, you know.
Here's the Boston youth line, Busek number 9.
His play was terrific. I mean, he was a goal scorer. You look at his record, very consistent.
Busek scores!
Taken for granted. Go with the puck, playmaker. He's kind of like a, you know, little dart in and out and tip, but greater than that.
He also was one of our greatest players.
Zdeno Chara, the captain of the Boston Bruins. Across to Chara, he scores! Zdeno Chara rips it home.
But you got to play defense. This is his priority. This is why he's such a dominant player when he's on top of his game.
Clapper over to Chara. He walks in. He scores! Zdeno Chara!
Recchi over to Lemieux, cuts in, got Recchi open, going for the net. He puts a shot on it. Shouts and scores! The wrecking ball makes it 3-0.
64th.
Even though he's in the Hall of Fame, I still think he's one of the most underrated players that ever played.
I never really considered myself a goal scorer. I still don't feel I'm a goal scorer. I feel that I'm a two-way hockey player that can put the puck in the net.
Gretner goes around the net, tucks it in, he scores! Getting to the corner, center of the net, goal! Gretner, big drive, score! Mike Gretner is in the house!
Kirk Broda stops the long shot and stops Bocour on the rebound. Kirk Broda blocks it and the puck rolls wide. But Broda comes far out to make a spectacular save. Steve Black passes out to Claire Martin. Martin's driving shot is stopped by Broda, hockey's fabulous Batman.
Cusick coming down along, gets set for a shot, let it go, and Power made the save and covered up.
Moore to Henri Richard got one, and Power caught it and held on to it.
Kempion closes and he shoots. Oh, and Power made a great save.
Try and check him, and he swats them away like flies. Delay Lindros. Lindros. Ricky with him. Lindros. Oh. Take the roof off, baby. Lindros. Score. 300 for Eric Lindros.
He may be the only player in this game who cannot be stopped when he puts his mind to wanting something.
Matt Sundin, he was a pretty special guy on and off the ice.
Doesn't shoot it to Sundin. Score.
Tony was one of the greatest goaltenders of all time, without a doubt. If he couldn't do it the best, he didn't want to do it.
I dedicated my life to playing goal, and I really did. I gave everything I had, and I put it above everything.
Francis King Clancy was a fiery personality in the National Hockey League. For the first 9 years of his career, Clancy played for his hometown Ottawa Senators. Clancy was acquired by the Toronto Maple Leafs in 1930, and 2 years later, he led them to their first cup in franchise history.
A fierce competitor who was known to grow incensed at being scored upon in practice, Perrant's statistics were staggering as the Flyers rose to prominence.
Yeah, with Perrant, I don't think that any goaltender in the history of the game put 2 years together like Bernie did those 2 years that we won the Cup. But I don't think anybody could play like Bernie could, particularly in a big game.
Drew's a guy that such intensity while he's playing, but has so much fun.
Doughty shoots, he scores!
He's an exciting player to watch because he's fearless.
Drew Doughty, old school stuff.
Phenomenal talent.
That was blocked on the line. Was that Doughty?
Kings have won two cups. Doughty has certainly been a key member of that team.
Another name to watch out for is Evgeny Malkin, as usual for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Evgeny Malkin, how about that?
That goal.
Don't call it a goal.
What do you call it, a masterpiece?
Of course.
Make me a milkshake, Malkin.
Conn Smythe Trophy
That's
winner
right.
in 2009, big-time player.
A hat trick for Gino.
Over the line, cutting in on goal. He can score.
Dave Keown danced on his skates. He was very heart and soul of the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Over the blue line, around Del Vecchio. He shoots, he scores! And the Leaf players have won the Stanley Cup.
That's when I believed that I could play in the NHL.
Jonathan Toews, and this guy is number one, the ultimate leader.
Jonathan Toews just continues to find ways to score.
Save by Raspino, he scores! Jonathan Toews!
Boy, oh boy, he's showing his leadership again and what Jonathan Toews is all about, one of the best players in the National Hockey League.
Still to come, we continue counting down the top 100 players of all time, featuring two current players who call the Windy City home. Where will these Chi-Town superstars fall on our countdown? Find out next. Welcome back to the top 100 players of all time. For more than 20 years, Grant Fuhr was a feared figure between the pipes. As a member of the Edmonton Oilers, Fuhr anchored the team to four Stanley Cup championships in the 1980s. Let's jump back into our countdown with Grant Fuhr at number 75.
And goal number 31, Grant Fuhr.
Penalty coming up. First shot. Oh, what a save by Fuhr.
Winning is always a lot of fun. And as long as you're winning, it makes the game go by a lot quicker.
At the center of the Buffalo's dreaded French Connection line, Gilbert Perreault lived up to his top billing.
10 years ago, I was playing with Rene Robert and Rick Martin, and I owned them a lot, you know, from 500.
Always be proud to be a Serber.
Ted Kennedy could do everything but skate. He was never a very pretty skater, but he was very industrious. He would do anything that it took to win.
You respected him as an opponent, and he was a tough one.
What made him special was that he went out with grit and determination to make sure he did his job every time he went out on the ice.
He was a great, great centerman. One of the greatest centermen Toronto Maple Leafs ever had.
Left Dickie Moore at 26, a six-year NHL veteran and a 29-goal scorer this campaign.
Across to Dickie Moore, Eugene Godfrey on the screen, and scores!
One of the most exciting goals of the championship. Harvey to Geoffrion to Moore. A headlong dive over Simmons.
One of the all-time greats in Montreal. He was just a marvelous player.
Robitaille becomes just the 13th player in NHL history to score 600 goals.
Luc Robitaille has got one of the best pair of hands ever to play in this league.
The New Jersey Devils select Brendan Shanahan.
Lubelier back, dropped to Shanahan, the shot, he scores! First NHL goal!
It's Brendan Shanahan, and that's number 600!
Great smile there from Shanny. 1,000 points.
Pavel Bure, what a career. What a remarkable journey through the NHL.
Pavel Bure works. Pavel Bure.
So explosive, you'd look up, he'd be at the opposing blue line, and next thing you know, seemingly shot out of a cannon, he'd come in on a breakaway.
What a show. The Russian Rocket put on the show tonight.
As the very first recipient of the Vezina Trophy, George Hainsworth was a remarkable netminder for the Canadiens and later the Maple Leafs. For 9 seasons, Hainsworth led the league in games played, still holds the two best single-season goals against averages of all time with 1.05 and 0.92 in 1928 and 29 respectively, and secured a total of 94 shutouts over his 12-year career in the National Hockey League.
A powerful skater and a brilliant stick hammer, Mahovlich scored 20 goals in his first 5 Major League competition. He won the Calder Trophy as the league's outstanding rookie of the year.
Over to the big M, he drags it ahead, and look at him turn it on. Now watch that move. Boy, you don't see that more than 1 or 2 times a year.
The first star, Frank Mahovlich.
We have been amazed and marveling at the play from the Blackhawks, number 88.
Skill in the dash and the flash. And Patrick Kane, in my mind, is the best player in the NHL.
Wow, what a play by Kane!
You're probably not going to be able to stop him.
But Patrick Kane, that's his 100th point!
And dug out by Kane, jammed in! A hat-trick!
Superstar professional scorer, just making it look easy.
The tireless skater, the person who would drive any opponent nuts
He could beat more individuals with his speed and then give you the puck in the open.
Dicky Moore passing to Henri Richard, who scores to give Montreal a 2-0 lead.
On the first start with Henry, he was exceptional. What else can you say about a hockey player that's been on 11 Stanley Cups?
Now Salming, obviously a talented player. You have to give him credit for having lasted this long.
Salming turns and shoots and scores.
Salming, by far the best player in this building, a brilliant display by a seasoned veteran.
Here comes Forsberg, wide in a shot, he scores! What a tremendous shot by Peter Forsberg!
Forsberg stumbles, keeps it in, and here he goes. Forsberg walking in, tees it up, waits, takes a shot, scores! Peter Forsberg with another beauty. What a player.
In Winnipeg, they don't call him the franchise. They haven't labeled him as the safe, one of the most talented centers to emerge from the Canadian junior ranks for some time.
Howardchuk turns. He scores!
Carlisle at the line. He sends it across. Howardchuk scores! Boy, they set that up nice. And a power play goal.
And number 10, Dale Howardchuk of the Winnipeg Jets.
Al MacInnis is such a big key for the Calgary Flames on the power play. He's developed into a pretty good two-way defenseman for Coach Terry Critton.
MacInnis comes to the blue line, takes the shot, scores!
Most goalies in the National Hockey League will tell you that he has the hardest shot in the league.
And there we go! Over 100 for Al MacInnis. And it's been a couple of years since we've seen that.
Blake moves up along the boards. Curry with him. Blake pulls right in. Score!
Fulton's shot is blocked. Grimson knocked down and score. Rob Blake has a hat trick.
Rob Blake was timeless. A unanimous choice for the Hockey Hall of Fame.
Thornton tied with Jaromir Jagr for the NHL scoring lead. And the Sharks get on the board. Here's Joe Thornton now. He'll give it to Vlasic. Up ice to Pavelski, who scores! And Joe Thornton has his 1,000th NHL assist. The playmaker of his generation.
Well, our next All-Star is certainly a man of distinction because he was the only member of the All-Star team that didn't come from Chicago. Toronto's Tim Horton.
He goes out there and he gives you everything he's got. He's a great inspiration for a hockey club.
Horton gets the puck right here at the blue line, and look at this for stick handling. This is just amazing.
Yeah, this is the prettiest goal of the night.
Just a great person and a great team man.
McDonald has it for Chicago. Back to Palat. Stopped by Stanley. Fight for the last shot.
During his 13 years with the Chicago Blackhawks, Pierre Palat was feared around the league. Between 1962 and 65, Palat won the Norris Trophy and was selected for the first All-Star team in each of those years. He led the league six times in games played and won a Stanley Cup championship with the Blackhawks in 1961.
Here's Madonna. The shot, he scores!
Mike Modano, he's certainly one of the best, if not the best, all-time Americans ever to play the game.
A shot, save, rebound, there it is! 500! And Mike Modano has a breakaway. Mike Modano can set the record, and he scores! He is the greatest American-born scorer of all time.
Now, we all know about his skill as a player. Genius is the ability to reduce the complicated to the simple, and Doug Gilmour is perfectly described by that definition of the word genius.
Gilmour shot, the second goes in!
Oh, he just shattered the glass.
He slammed the door and it went poof.
Now, is he showcasing himself or what?
So much starts off of the stick of Duncan Keith.
Well, he's got the hardware. 2010, 13, and 15. He's got a couple of Norris trophies to boot. He's got a Conn Smythe trophy. And he's got two gold medals. He plays with an edge. There's no doubt about that.
Has led them in ice time for 11 consecutive seasons. What a player he has been.
You could just tell when Sergei Fedorov came on the ice,
that he wanted something out of this game.
Sergei Fedorov, a shot, scores! Fedorov!
One of the best Russians ever to play in the National Hockey League.
What a beautiful goal that was.
With all due respect to Wayne Gretzky, this player right now is the best in the NHL.
Larry Jeffrey on the Montreal Canadiens.
Slapshot changed hockey forever. And there was the boom boom.
And here it is with another jet-like drive by Boom Boom Jeffrey on. Boom Boom Jeffrey on scores with a tremendous shot.
Back come the Canadiens. Jeffrey on with one man back. Jeffrey on shoots. He scores!
It is my honor and privilege to introduce Milton Schmidt.
Milton Schmidt, number 15, scores a picture goal. A pass to Dumart. Back to Schmidt. He shoots, he scores.
I feel very proud and privileged to have been part of one of the most storied organizations in hockey, let alone of all sports.
Coming up next, our countdown of the top 100 players of all time rolls on with a pair of skaters that put an end to the 1940 chant in the Big Apple. Find out where these Stanley Cup heroes rank after the break.
Avalanche have won the Stanley Cup!
Unbelievable!
Welcome back to the top 100 players of all time. From 1979 to 1984, the Triple Crown line reigned supreme in Tinseltown. LA Kings forwards Marcel Dion, Charlie Simmer, and Dave Taylor exhilarated fans during those years and became one of the highest scoring lines in hockey history. Time now to dive right back into our countdown with a member of this storied line at number 50.
My first game in the NHL, it's when I'm standing, I'm in the starting lineup, I'm standing in the at the blue line, and that's it now. This is for real.
Dion from the top of the slot with the 611th goal of his NHL career.
Save, rebound, Dion scores!
He is only the third player in the National Hockey League history to score 1,500 points.
Brian Leetch is put a huge exclamation point in front of the best as far as the league's concerned.
The first American-born player to ever win the Conn Smythe Trophy.
Leetch hit fast, scores! What a burst of speed by Brian Leetch!
What a hockey player this Brian Leetch.
In 5, 4, 3, 2.
They don't cut much taller than Chris Pronger. Big, solid, skilled, and smart.
Pronger shot, he scores!
I do consider myself a physical player, yes.
Big hit by Chris Pronger.
I love watching him. I love covering him.
The guy they call Captain Happy.
Boy, he was a winner.
That's a wrap. Cut it.
Stastny's around again. Peter Stastny scores.
Here's Anton Stastny. Peter Stastny going with it and goal. He scores. Peter Stastny.
And it's center. Boom, score. Stastny. Stastny.
Lemieux. Center. Stastny scores.
32nd player in the history of the National Hockey League to score 400 goals in his career, and this was not a cheap one.
A great goalie like Bill Dernan uses the stick, his hands, his body or legs, all of which are well padded. And it takes a stout heart and courage to dive headfirst into a whirlwind of steel blades and wooden sticks to cover that puck.
This goaltender was selected to the first All-Star team on 5 occasions and twice played on Stanley Cup champions. A 6-time winner of the Vezina Trophy from the Montreal Canadiens, Bill Dernan.
The Bruins, there's the fellow they have to depend on back in the blue line.
Park with it, scores! Brad Park wins the game!
Here's Brad Park, the drive, he scores!
This puck was in all the way, and Jacques Vaughn never had a chance to follow it.
Brad Park shoots, he scores! Did Park look like an artist at work, or did he not?
A brilliant play by Park, bang, bang, all the way.
Gretzky gets it! In front to Curry! He scores!
Curry looking for his 500! Curry
shoots. He scores! His 500th NHL goal.
Here's Sakic, holds it in, drops it back out on the point. Center scores!
Ovechkin fires, he scores! Alexander Ovechkin, welcome on board! Ovechkin fires, he scores!
65 goals, 112 points, the MVP all the way.
Welcome to the club, number 500!
Cruising on in, Tokarev scores! 1,000 points!
The greatest still yet to come.
Now here's Kropke, scores!
Back to the point. Pearson, green shot, score! And it was tipped in front by Trottier, who now has tied the NHL record for points in a playoff year at 27.
Look at Trottier. They just can't handle the bigger Pittsburgh Penguins forward. And there's the good low shot by Brian Trottier.
Gordie Howe's bullet shot drives McNeil to the ice. From the side of the left, Ken Lindsay pokes in the loose puck.
It's been a wonderful city to me. I came here in 1944, and the city and the state have just been great to me, and for the rest of my life, I'll try to repay them in some way.
Each year, the most outstanding player, as voted by the NHL Players Association, receives the Ted Lindsay Award. That must make you feel pretty special, Ted.
Yeah, yes, it certainly does.
I am proud to welcome to New Jersey, Scott Niedermeyer.
Niedermeyer trying to get back, got it! How did Scott Niedermeyer have that kind of acceleration? Here's Niedermeyer, he can fly. Niedermeyer reshaped the trailer. Niedermeyer just missed. Niedermeyer scores! Scott Niedermeyer! The Devils win the Stanley Cup! Rob Niedermeyer back to Scott for a shot. He scores!
The winner of the Conn Smythe Trophy, Scott Niedermeyer.
Somebody that was physical, that intimidated, that somebody is Scott Stevens. Look at what he can do. He's so imposing, he could be Zeus.
When you see a guy coming out down the wing with his head down, the alarm go off for you.
Yeah, it doesn't happen too often anymore if they know not to do that.
But what a hit on Stevens! Crushes Shane Willis!
Who does it better in the National Hockey League?
The France shooting! Scores! Ronnie Francis drills one by Hanlon. Lee Bruins back defensively while Francis shoots, he scores! What a play by Ronnie Francis. Francis comes in, shoots, and scores! Ronnie Francis! Next, here's Francis, he scores!
He scores! Ron Francis in front of the net!
I don't know whether there are many players who have a passion for the game to any greater degree than Chelios.
He is a unique individual when it comes to intensity. I mean, here's a guy that continues to play over 1,000 games. He's in that club.
Belfort through traffic, able to stop it nicely. Oh, Chelios having a man in the corner.
His image is that of a warrior on the ice.
One of the best leaders in the game of hockey, one of the finest players in the league, Chris Chelios.
And we're looking now at Glenn Hall of the Chicago Blackhawks, one of the great goaltenders in the business of hockey.
A rebound to Russo. A remarkable save by Glenn Hall.
Well, I think it's getting more difficult for a goalkeeper all the time. The style of hockey is more goals, and it gets increasingly more difficult.
Eight-time Stanley Cup champion, Red Kelly.
They're introducing Red Kelly as one of the 25 best Leafs. There was no doubt this guy wouldn't be on that team.
The dream was to play in the NHL, play with the Toronto Maple Leafs, and to win a Stanley Cup. But I never, ever dreamed that I'd be hung from the top of the building.
Vladimir Ovechkin, number 29. Ken Dryden.
Behind the Roberto McKenzie. Great save, Dryden. The pad, the arm, the glove always seems to be there.
And this save on Patton is typical of the way Dryden is frustrating the Blackhawks.
The Dryden was big, tall. Look at the size of this guy. He almost looks unorthodox with that equipment. But boy, oh boy.
There were seven or eight extremely good right wingers that year in the draft. But as far as pure ability to score goals, there wasn't anybody close to me.
Shoots, he scores! Mike Bossy has his 50th goal!
Boss
Yes, he got the goal. What an ability this guy has to score goals.
500, Mike Bossy.
He becomes the 11th in league history to score 500.
Big Barry Robinson, he's quite a hockey player, probably the best defenseman in the National Hockey League.
It comes to Robinson, closing in.
Larry was a complete player. He was a great offensive player. He was a great defensive player, good team player, and he was very tough.
Big, tough, strong, skilled, and funny. Just a terrific character.
One of the most explosive forwards of the National Hockey League, Teemu Selänne.
You want to talk about a hockey player. This Selänne is something else.
Selänne goes after it. Teemu Selänne breaks it. He scores!
This is absolutely incredible.
Sliding save, and that's good. There it is. Number 600.
Get some tickets and watch this kid Selänne play hockey. He is a piece of work.
After the break, we continue counting down the top 100 players of all time, featuring the first netminder to ever wear a mask in the NHL. Where will this trendsetter and supremely intelligent goalie rank on our countdown? Find out next.
Avalanche have won the Stanley Cup! Unbelievable!
Welcome back to the top 100 players of all time. As an expansion team in 1972, the New York Islanders were almost instant contenders. Due to their core of young talent, the Islanders burst out of the gate and went on to capture four consecutive Stanley Cup championships between 1980 and 1983. Let's get back into our countdown at number 30 with a member of this dynasty.
Denny Potvin, he's one of the rare breed of defensemen who can do it both ways, defensively and offensively.
In goes Potvin. Good save, the rebound, he scores! The Dallas Potvin scores!
He has been an absolutely magnificent figure.
His father's a hockey legend, and now Brett Hull skates out of his father's shadow.
Turgeon, front to Hull, a shot, he scores!
There's no sense in doing something unless you want to do it really well.
Many years as I play, I just want to become a better player.
The goal that Brett has scored, his golden goal! Brett Hull gets his 700th NHL goal!
But even in this building, you can hear Blackhawk fans now yelling, Eddie, Eddie. That's how spectacular Belfour has played tonight.
I said that white glove was working magic.
Wow. How in the world did he make that save?
Oh, gee, yeah, just look at that. That's unbelievable. That is unbelievable.
You know, the old equalizer is hard work. Some guys have a lot of ability, but, you know, they don't work as hard.
Well, Bobby Clark is recognized everywhere as a hockey superstar.
Fight to Clark. Shot. Oh, rebound. Score!
Clark fires and scores. His 900 career playoff points. An amazing hockey player, an amazing man, Bobby Clark.
And here to go. Here's a chance for a shot. Goal by Stan Mikita.
He was a great, great NHLer. I mean, he led the league in scoring, won the Hart Trophy, and won the Stanley Cup. He's one of the best.
Oh, back to Mikita. Mikita, he shot the goal! That wonderful stick handling by Mikita.
Two-time MVP, four-time Hart Trophy winner.
He's a great athlete. He's just all around there.
Paul Coffey broke my record. He's going to shatter them. He's a phenomenal skater, and more in the style of a Bobby Orr.
Bobby on a rush, right in, shoot, scores! 24-year-old Paul Coffey shatters Bobby Orr's record. Incredible!
We'll always remember his 21 seasons of dazzling speed and skill, while opponents remember the blur of Paul Coffey gliding unstoppingly by them.
Well, the all-time greats, Guy Lafleur.
This man has captured everyone's hearts tonight.
And the flower came through.
He gives it into the mayor, back to Lafleur. He
scores! He shoots, he scores! Guy Lafleur gets the goal!
For 10 years, he was the best player in the league, and there was no contest.
there is Sakic. Sakic inside the line. Sundin and Fred scores!
Sakic just plays with it and plays with it. He does an excellent job of protecting the puck with his body.
The winner of the Conn Smythe Trophy is Joe Sakic.
It is 600! Number 600 for Super Joe!
In front of Pacino scores!
I love playing Boston. I love to play in Boston.
Flipped it back to Esposito. Got five! And for Esposito, his 50th goal of the year.
My life is have been my number every time. I think that it's absolutely the greatest you could ever be honored in hockey.
6 times in 7 seasons, beginning in the mid-50s, Jacques Plante won the Vezina Trophy. The temperamental and often explosive Plante was probably the most frustrating of all netminders for the opposing forward.
Plante made a phenomenal save that time, and that was right in on
him. The 5 years that the Canadiens won their consecutive cups, Jacques Plante was the best goaltender I ever saw.
We were in the entertainment business. If I could excite those people, then I'm doing the job that I think I should be doing.
Bobby Hull has broken the all-time scoring record of 51 goals in a single season. It's Bobby Hull's score! Just scored 600 National Hockey League goals! And the fans in Boston give a great hand to one Robert Marvin Hull.
I like going with the puck, and I like setting up maybe plays or I could skate with the puck.
Horton fires, scores!
I had the pleasure of playing with Bobby Orr, and although there'll never be another Bobby Orr, Ray worked as a poise of a Bobby Orr, and he's got everything going for him.
After 22 years!
Well, everything that's happened to me, never would I have thought I would accomplish in the NHL.
Probert, cross ice for Yzerman. Yzerman makes the move on Manson. Shot!
The Conn Smythe Trophy, Steve Yzerman.
And Yzerman picks it up at the side of the goal, and centering pass, he scores! Number 600, it's a scandy goal with the Joe for Stevie Y.
With a slim one-goal lead, the pressure on the goalkeeper is tremendous. A brilliant save by Sochuk.
Terry Sochuk juggles Olmstead's shot, but bats it clear.
Lehman gets a chance, and Sochuk smothered it.
Terry Sochuk easily catches McKay's slap shot.
Lloyd Curry passes across to Joffrion, but his shot is expertly caught by Terry Sochuk.
There's only one way to play hockey in the National League. Play it for keeps every game.
Eddie Shore was such a great player that owner Charles F. Adams bought an entire hockey league to acquire his services.
Eddie Shore fortified the strong Boston defense under the able Art Ross.
He was really virtuoso. He was generally the best skater there was. He was stronger than anybody. He was tougher than anybody.
He's not that big, but he's ruthless. He's crazy. He's the ultimate hockey player.
Howie Morenz was the first real offensive hero. This guy was the star. And it was all about speed, scoring, dedication, fearlessness.
I believe when Winter Carter's sixth sense, he was the most natural hockey player that I ever seen or played with.
Howie Morenz was really the heart and the soul, not just of his own team, but probably of the NHL.
Patrick Roy seems to be enjoying this game.
And Doug Wilson rifles it. Rebound! Oh, what a save by Patrick Roy! You gotta see that one again a couple of times, folks.
We have a new career playoff leader in wins with 89. It is Patrick Roy.
Passion, ability, and just that maturity of Patrick Roy have enabled him to get this place.
There's no greater hockey player in my mind than Doug Harvey.
He would dare you to come and try to get the puck away.
Harvey shows why he was named to the National League's All-Star team. His ice generalship is a real highlight as he blocks Detroit pass out.
He could just control everything.
The best defenseman that I played with.
He could change the tempo of a game to our favor at all times.
Messier is certainly the soul of the team.
Over the Islander blue line, Messier moves through the defense and scores!
Messier, Messier, shot, score!
experience. And I don't think there's a better player in the league than Mark Messier.
It's a name, damn it. Maybe it was or maybe still my nickname.
If you can't stop it one way, folks, you stop it another.
Look at this.
Down, 10 to go on our countdown of the top 100 players of all time, including the all-time winningest goalie in hockey history. Where will this devilish netminder land on our countdown?
You're number one, Marty. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Stick around to find out.
Avalanche have won the Stanley Cup! Unbelievable!
Welcome back to the top 100 players of all time. Let's take a look back at the icons that have made our list so far.
How about what Henrik Lundqvist has accomplished?
Oh, he did score!
The Secretary of Defense.
Dick Clapper was a leader.
He's the strongest goalie, most flexible goalie.
This guy, he can do it all now.
Denny Savard, number 18. Murphy, a drive. He scores!
Curry Savard is the veteran of our defense.
He's playing this terrific. I mean, he's a goal scorer.
Zdeno Chara rips it home.
The wrecking ball makes it 3-0.
Hockey's fabulous fat man.
Power making a nice save on that one.
Take the roof off, baby!
Matt Sundin, he was a pretty special guy.
Tony was one of the greatest goaltenders of all time.
King Clancy was a fiery personality.
I don't think anybody could play like Bernie could.
Drew Doughty, old school stuff.
Evgeny Malkin, how about that?
Dave Keown danced on his skates.
Jonathan Taves, the ultimate leader.
Oh, you're robbed him!
Gilbert Perreault lived up to his top billing.
He was a great, great centerman.
One of the all-time greats in Montreal.
Oh, what a goal! It's Brendan Shanahan.
Pavel Bure, what a career.
George Hainsworth was a remarkable netminder.
The first star, Frank Mihaljevic.
Skill in the dash and the flash.
Not the first star, but Henry, he was exceptional.
Now, Salming, obviously a talented player.
Peter Forsberg with another beauty.
Power jump turns, he scores!
McKenna takes the shot, scores! Blake pulls right in, scores!
The playmaker of his generation!
Just a great person and a great team man.
Pierre Pilote was feared around the league.
Here's Modano, scores!
Is he showcasing himself or what?
What a player he has been. This player right now is the best in the NHL.
Milt Schmidt scores a picture goal.
Dion scores!
What a hockey player this Brian Leach.
Big hit by Chris Pronger.
From the Montreal Canadiens, Bill Dernan.
Scores! Brad Burke! Yari Curry has just scored!
Ovechkin fires, he scores!
Krapke, scores!
Ken Lindsay pokes in the loose puck.
Scott Niedermeyer.
Big number four, bang.
Ronnie Francis.
One of the best leaders in the game of hockey.
And we're looking now at Glenn Hall.
Red Kelly.
Boy, oh boy, was Dryden ever good.
Bossy got the goal.
Scores!
This Solani is something else.
Brett Hull skates out of his father's shadow. It's in Belfour's glove, I don't believe it!
You know, the old equalizer is hard work.
He's a great, great NHLer.
One of the all-time greats, Guy Lafleur.
Number 600 for Super Joe! And Esposito scores!
God, and it's worth it, this crap! Bobby Hulkin scores!
Scores! Playboy!
Steve Yzerman.
A brilliant save by Thotchuk.
He was really virtuoso.
Lenz had, I believe, what they call a sixth sense.
Patrick Roy seems to be enjoying this game.
He could just control everything.
Messi is certainly the soul of the team.
Passion! Holy mackerel!
Let's wrap up our countdown with the top 10 players of all time.
There is nobody else that does everything he does.
And we marvel at him sometimes with how good he is.
Sidney Crosby with a big
the best player in the world is Sidney Crosby.
The first European-born captain to lead his team to the Stanley Cup. 7 Norris trophies.
Oh! Sensational play by Nicklas
Lidstrom. Absolutely fantastic.
There are so many reasons people think he is the best NHL defenseman. He wins that Norris Trophy routinely. That was another example of his genius right there.
Happy now to have with us, first of all, on my right, the great Jean Beliveau.
Beliveau, Jeffrey Bonnet, back to Beliveau, and score!
Because they seem like they won it every second year, you always remember Jean Beliveau lifting the Stanley Cup.
Perrier winds up for the shot, looks like a double net, they score! Beliveau!
The classiest guy that ever played in the National Hockey League. They loved him in Montreal, they loved him all over the league, and we as players had so much respect for the way he carried himself as he played against us.
I've never found one more completely dedicated to his sport as Rocket Richard.
And Montreal's colorful Rocket Richard, hockey's greatest goal scorer,
one of the world's finest athletes, scores his 500th goal. The Rocket is undoubtedly a superstar.
I never tried to make the same move all the time, and I think the goalie never knew what I was going to do.
That man built the game of hockey up one during his career, and it helped a lot of them make a fine living after.
Jagr on the right wing, hooks from behind. Interference by McLean, but he gets to the net. Jagr scores!
Oh, boy.
I don't know if he'll ever top that one.
What a sensational goal. Great second effort.
That will go down as one of the great highlight goals of all time.
Jagr keeps it in. Jagr in alone, score!
What a sensational goal.
The 700th goal of his National Hockey League career.
In a normal reaction, no player is going to be able to do that. Jagr did.
You're looking at simply a marvelous, marvelous hockey player.
His first shot on goal, and he scores! Mario Lemieux living up quickly to all the advertisements. Now Lemieux, and there's number 500, Mario Lemieux.
Mario holds on along the board, beats the slot, hunts him, he shoots, he scores! It is his 1,700th National Hockey League point.
There it is.
Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, Detroit's number 9, Mr. Hockey, Gordie Howe.
Good evening, I'm Gordie Howe.
I don't think we'll ever see another Gordie Howe.
Power, grace, he had it all. Physical, had toughness. He was a complete player.
And from the Hartford Whalers, representing all of hockey with great distinction for 5 decades, number 9.
What he's meant to the game for so long, and I don't think we'll ever see anybody like this guy.
I feared playing against him, you know. He had an image, and he was a living legend, and, you know, he took my breath away.
Bobby Orr, behind the net to Sanderson, no!
Heading down to the Boston zone, and who was there to look you square in the face and break up the play was Bobby Orr. Who was the first guy down to your end leading the rush? Bobby Orr. Who was the guy making the play from behind the net? Bobby Orr. Bobby Orr was ushering in a new era for defense.
My biggest concern here is to enjoy myself and have a lot of fun, and that's all I'm concerned with.
Gretzky's still out there. Here he goes after the puck. Wayne Gretzky in on goal.
Has never failed to amaze us. He just has such an uncanny ability to do what he wants to do when he wants to do it. And that's what I mean about one player dominating his or her sport. And Gretzky has done that in the National Hockey League.
The great one has become the greatest of them all.
Never quantify what Wayne Gretzky has meant. He is the most valuable player of his time.
There it is, the top 100 players of all time. For a league that has spanned a century, the NHL has seen its fair share of greatness on the ice, but it takes more than proficient stick handling and innate talent to become a legend in the game. From the men who set the standards to the ones who broke the records, these are skaters that are synonymous with the sport. For NHL Network, I'm Michelle McMahon. We'll see you next time.